Isla. Why did you come here?
Because I had to hear from you in person. I have to know why you did it. Why did you kill her?
Isla. I was on the road coming back from Thunder Bay when Norma was killed. I couldn't say exactly where I was. My job, I worked in cash. I didn't have no receipts. I didn't have no credit card transactions. I had no alibi.
So you're saying that you didn't do it?
I loved your mother. I wouldn't hurt her.
You researched everything. The jury found you guilty in 10 minutes.
10 whole minutes. To decide a man's fate, does it sound to you like the jury did its job?
You had lawyers.
You mean my public defender? He didn't call a single character witness. The police, they never interviewed nobody but me. They figured dead wife, it has to be the husband, right?
Inmate.
I'm sorry. I try to put focus on the positive things, you know, just the memories of your mom and you. I didn't want you to have to deal with this. I wanted you to have a normal life. And look how you turned out.
Still, whatever happened, whatever you did, you had no right to lie to me. No one did. And you're my father, and I deserve to know the truth.
You're right. And I'm sorry. I just want you to be happy. Oh, hey. Hey. It's okay.
Could you tell me more about Mom?
Thank you.
your emergency?
My niece, Isla, she's missing. I think she might have been kidnapped.
Sir, I'm gonna need your full name.
Dr. Nathan Wallis. I'm her legal guardian.
How old is your niece?
She's 16.
Checking out?
Yeah, you're the cop. I'll pound my car if I don't leave by tonight, so.
If you don't mind me asking, who were you visiting in prison? You know what? Never mind. It's none of my business.
It's okay. I was visiting my dad, Thomas Perot.
Oh.
It's fine. I just... Forget it.
Did you want to grab something to eat? Her mom was beautiful. You look a lot like her.
So you really don't think your dad killed her, eh?
I know how that sounds, but I want to believe him.
And you're hoping there's a clue somewhere in these articles.
Okay, well, it doesn't look like there are any broken windows, so it doesn't sound like a burglary.
Right. So whoever killed my mom, she might have let him into the house.
Maybe she knew him. Does your mom have any family over here that we can talk to?
It's just me, my uncle, and my aunt, and we moved to Toronto when I was 3. But maybe where she worked, at social services.
They close in an hour. Let's go. We can't risk Pringle seeing your car, so I'll drive.
Last time I saw you, you couldn't have been 3 years old. Your mom brought you in for our Christmas party, dressed up as Rudolph, red nose and everything.
So do you know anyone who may have had a problem with my mom, anyone who didn't like her?
Norma never had a crossroad with anyone. Mind you, the folks that she worked with were troubled.
Well, who are her clients?
Well, most of her cases must still be here. Okay, well, here are some of Norma's girls. Most of them lived on the res, some got pregnant. Okay, this one, Audrey. Oh, Audrey, she had substance problems. Norma thought she was dealing. She really struggled with what to do about it.
Wow, these girls on the res sound kind of sketchy.
Norma told me she thought about turning her in, but was afraid of repercussions from the boyfriend, who was white. I can't believe the police didn't look into this. I didn't believe your father was guilty, not for a second. Tom adored your mother.
Do you think we could get copies of these?